welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today is Valentine's Day and we're not going to be cooking in the kitchen today, but Rick and I are going on a trip and you get to come along. We are going to Shaker Village at Pleasant Hill, Kentucky, and that is commonly known as Shakertown. Now I have done a video already of lunch at Shakertown, which you might want to look up if you're interested, but this time we're going to spend the night. And we've spent the night before, but we haven't done a video on it. And it's been many years ago, way before updates like Wi-Fi and stuff like that. But this is still a very old community and shows a lot of the old crafts, the old ways of doing things. So it's quite interesting. This is going to be a special Valentine's event. So we'll be having dinner there and we'll have brunch tomorrow morning. In between, I don't know if there's going to be champagne or sweets or what, but there's going to be something special. So we're looking forward to the trip, and we'll see you at Shakertown, which is about 40 or 45 miles from where we live. Here's what the countryside looks like as we approach Shaker Village at Pleasant Hill. And you can see there's a house up on the hill there. You can see we have some stone fences on each side of the road. Getting pretty close.
Arriving at destination on right.
I think we are arriving. And this appears to be our turn. So turning in here. You might notice the rain on the windows. It's just sprinkling just a bit. Just a mist. And we'll go to the hotel check-in, which is up in this direction. So I'm going to show you the hotel in just a minute. You can see this is the outside, so we'll be seeing you on the inside. And Rick is over at the desk getting us checked in. And I think our room is ready, so we'll be seeing you in the room. This is the building that we'll be staying in. And I just want to show you what it looks like. We're parked at a temporary parking spot so we can get unloaded. And there's Rick. He's loaded down with some suitcases. So I'm going to grab some stuff and close our trunk lid here and go inside and we'll get settled in. We've been inside our building for just a few minutes and I want to show you. This is a room that we came back to. There's where we're going to get our ice. And looks like there is a microwave over in the corner and a refrigerator down below. And those are probably shared by all of these rooms because every room doesn't have those individual items. There's a coffee maker here with some coffee and sweetener and so on. Coke machine, our garbage pail. And here's a fireplace. And what you're going to notice about Shaker Village is that it's very rustic. And you'll find that it's very old. The floors are of boards that must be hundreds of years old. And as we go in this direction, I know this floor is slippery because both Rick and I almost slipped on it. But I want to show you that you could come in the evening and you could play cards or whatever. Over here is like a card table, a place for four people to sit. Here's a little game that's called Skittles. And they probably make those here, I'm not sure. We'll be seeing some crafts that they make, and they sell crafts here. But let's just continue on in the direction of our room. This is a sitting room, and it has a TV over there, and has a couple of rocking chairs. And you'll notice the style of furniture is very plain. And it is Shaker style, and the emphasis was on utility. And these are very functional items of furniture, but you will see that they're not carved and not ornate. They're very plain. And going on, let's keep going toward our room. And it's the one, is it 185?
Yeah.
Okay, ours is stairs, a couple of sets of stairs here, and there are two rooms upstairs. And over there is room 186. So this house I guess, is made for four rooms,
I think there are more than that.
Yeah, there's another stairway there. So there will be a third floor at least. More rooms. But this one is ours. Welcome to our humble abode for one night. You'll notice that we have a couple rocking chairs. They're really big on that. And here is a little end table, or a coffee table, I guess, and a lamp. And here, open this up, is a TV. It's small, but sufficient. And you can see we have a chest of drawers, which we're not going to put anything in it. We'll just live out our suitcases, probably. Over here is an ice bucket, and they have left us some Valentine candy, or I'm sorry, cookies. These are sugar cookies, and they are decorated with pink icing. Looks good. We'll try those in a minute. And this is the kind of thing you see as shaker furniture. These are shaker pegs, and you can hang all sorts of things on them, such as this candle holder. And this is a candle, but it's not like a wax candle, it's an electric type. And over here, the shaker pegs are a place that you could hang a cabinet like this. I see that the holes behind there of those strips are not in the pegs, on the pegs, so they're using another way. But you can hang a lot of things that way because they line the room all the way around. Over there's a mirror that is hanging on a shaker peg. And you notice the two beds here. This was what was left when we got our reservation, so that will be fine. There is an end table in between the two beds, and a phone, and a clock, and a lamp, and a chair. So that leaves the bathroom. There is a candle holder here, and I don't know. That turned on the light. Actually, both of them got turned on by that. And here, this is a little latch that I have to bring up to open the bathroom door. It has ceramic tile on the floor, and it's a very small bathroom. It has a very, very small bathtub, or just kind of an area for you to stand while you take a shower. And everything looks really clean, white towels, and plenty of them. And here is a hair dryer, so if I need to use that, I didn't bring one myself, so I might have to do that. And they have all the supplies that you need right at your fingertips.
Double pegged the bathroom. Even the shower has pegs.
Double pegged, two parallel lines all the way around. So I guess you can hang your robe, you can hang your pajamas, and then any towels or washcloths. So this is really utilitarian. Looks like a good start. There's Rick with the car to pick me up to go to eat dinner. And I saw some geese, and I thought I'd show you a picture. We've just gotten our menu from Shaker Village of Pleasant Hill. And I want to tell you what's on the menu. Relish bowl and corn sticks will be passed. Tomato celery soup. Now I've made that in Betty's kitchen. Soup of the day. Shaker Village coleslaw. Garden salad. Egg and aspic on anchovy toast. Our own chicken pot pie. Grilled center cut country ham steak. Beef burgundy. Crab cakes. Pan fried catfish. Shaker country tart of the day. Shaker dish of the day. Vegetables and village hot breads will be passed. And I'm sure they have dessert, but it's not on here. So Rick and I are going to think about this and decide what we're going to order. I want to show you that they just brought what they call their champagne toast. So Rick and I each have one of these for Valentine's Day. And we're going to start with those. Thank you. And here we have a relish tray. Looks like it's pickled okra.
That's right.
And also some pickles, tomatoes, and little baby corn, cauliflower, and carrots and celery, and some olives. We've just received our bread, and it's more than just corn sticks. There are a few very small corn sticks that would fall apart, excuse me. But it's steaming hot, looks good. There are also some little yeast rolls, I guess. So I'm going to use some of this nice butter that they brought, and that's the bread. We've received a couple things. I want to catch you up. I've got my iced tea here. It's unsweetened. And Rick has just his water. Oh, he has iced tea too. Sorry. Unsweetened. And to go with our corn sticks, and also we had rolls and butter. Here I have some soup. This is the tomato celery soup. And it is in Betty's kitchen if you want the recipe for it. It's delicious. That's why I ordered it. And Rick, what do you have?
I have a Shakertown coleslaw, which is sort of vinegary and tangy, and not the milky, very sweet coleslaw you usually find, but I like this very much.
Here's my dinner that I ordered. This is the grilled country ham steak. That's what it looks like, and it came on a plate by itself. And then they came around with bowls where you could dip out as much as you wanted of these are red potatoes and green beans and tomato casserole. So I just got a little bit of each one of those. I think it looks good. There he is.
Here I am. What I got, one of my favorite foods is crab patties, crab cakes. And I also had the tomato salad, the potatoes, and the green beans.
Looks pretty good, huh?
It sure does.
You look good.
Thanks. Our desserts have arrived. We had a choice of apple cake, lemon pie, or chess pie. I got the lemon pie. And this is a lemon pie made in a unique way. Betty's done it in Betty's kitchen after the last time we went to Shaker Village. It's made with the whole lemons. And it's a unique way. They didn't waste anything. They didn't waste the lemon rinds either. She got chess pie, which the server described it as pecan pie without the pecans. And Betty also has uploaded a version of chess pie, although I think her version is a little bit different from this one, perhaps. And Betty got coffee and cream. This is the famous spiral staircase at Shaker Village. It goes up and up and up. Beautiful feature. And the thing is that there are two of them identical, symmetrically placed. One was for the use of women, as I understand, one for men. Shakers were strict segregationists as far as the sexes were concerned, which may explain why they died out.
Here's a room that nobody is using right now. It's just a sitting room, and most everybody's having dinner right now, so this is vacant. But if you had a reservation for later in the evening and you got here, you could just sit in these rocking chairs and talk. There's a little stove over there. It's not operating right now. I don't know if it's operational. And then all these chairs sitting along. Room for everybody. Of course, there's nobody here right now. But it's just kind of a pleasant place to be because it is kind of out in the country and not overcrowded or anything. Very peaceful, a lot of wildlife, good scenery, and I think we're going to leave this building and go back to the building our room is at. Here we are back in the room, and we've had a nice meal. We're very full, so what we're going to do is exchange some gifts and cards that we got for each other and thought you might be interested. So Rick, here's a little card for you. That's a Monet painting.
And it says, Happy Valentine's Day to my darling husband, Rick. Love, Shine. Thank you, Shine.
I'm Shine, so anybody out there, don't worry. It's from me. And here's a card that Rick gave me.
My award-winning calligraphy on display there.
And it says, Joy on the front of it. Please be my Valentine. Rick, inside a heart, all my love. Isn't that cute? Thank you, Rick.
You're welcome.
That's sweet. Okay, I have a little gift for you. And here it is.
And strawberries. Not the gift, the revenue. Oh, this is a Nikon speed light. It's a flash unit for my new camera, which has built-in flash, but this is much better. You can do bounce flash and control the angle, and it's much more flattering light. And it's made for the camera. Thank you, dear.
You're welcome. Rick's really into his new camera, so he has to tell me what he needs, and then he can get it. So, do I have something to open now?
You do.
Okay, here goes. Interesting box wrapped in strawberry flavor. We share a lot of things. See what it is. Ah.
Well, remembrance of times gone by.
This is nostalgic because this is the cologne that I used to wear when we first met. And I haven't worn it for years, haven't smelled the scent of it. I think I'll put some on tonight. But I don't know that you can get this very easily. I think maybe there might be some online store.
Yes, you can do. Okay. Find about anything online.
But it's there were a few different fragrances that I did wear when I was dating Rick in college. And Taboo by Dana was one of them. Also did Chanel No. 5 and some of those old classics. Let's see what this smells like. Mmm. That bring back memories.
Oh, it's coming, yes. Classic Betty.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it looks like
and there's a bag with a few more goodies.
So this is mainly for me, but maybe partly for you. Is that what it is?
Possibly.
Okay.
Indirectly, at least.
To this bag. Ugh, right here. And the first thing I'm getting out here is a big book. The Complete America's Test Kitchen TV Show Cookbook, 2001 through 2012. That should get me busy for a while. I love to read cookbooks. I don't read any other books hardly at all. I used to read some novels and some things that are nonfiction, but I'm not really the kind of person that sits down and reads a novel, even though Rick writes novels, and he's got 3 on Amazon right now. I've told you about Cape Run. He also has Double and Title Search. In case anyone is interested, just go to Amazon, and his name is Richard Given. I'm trying to get this big book out here. This one is Cooks Illustrated. It says Cookbook, 2,000 recipes from 20 years of America's Most Trusted Food Magazine, which is aligned with America's Test Kitchen. So these two may have some overlapping recipes in them. And I noticed there's some more things in here.
But wait, there's more.
There's a tissue paper that was supposed to go around it, I guess.
never got done.
Never made it. Best Country Recipes from Cook's Country. Same thing, a different version, and same thing, a different version. So I will have a lot of fun reading those. But this is Cook's Country, which is still the same group that we're talking about. This is a DVD, season 2. This is season 1. And this is season 3. And this is season 4. So in order, they would be the first 4 seasons of Cook's Country. Anyway. This is a pretty happy Valentine's Day for me because I got a lot of stuff and we've had such a fun day. We're ending up our evening and we just wanted to exchange our gifts, and this room smells like perfume. Good night.
Good night.
We finished our breakfast here at Sugar Village off Pleasant Hill, and so we're going to get in the car and head back home. We enjoyed our Valentine's Day celebration yesterday and last night and this morning, and we're glad you came along.